Hi, I'm Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet, and today I'm going to talk to you about a freshly new spoiled card. I say freshly new, at the time of recording it was spoiled a day or so ago, by the time this comes out it could have been a week. But we're talking about Imperial Recruiter, the red 2/2 for 3 mana that lets you go find a thing in your deck. For those of you that don't know, Modern Horizons 2 is bringing in cards, new cards, injecting them straight into Modern and bypassing Standard. And well, we've been long overdue for a human that enters the battlefield and shooters for other creatures including humans. I guess I'm just pretty glad that humans isn't the bugbear, the boogeyman of the format that it once was, so that Imperial Recruiter doesn't just push the deck over the edge like a lot of human printings were doing in the past. My biggest disappointment about the addition of Imperial Recruiter to Modern and in Modern Horizons 2 is that Recruiter of the Guard isn't being added. Or, shall I say, we're just at the end of spoiler season now, it's unlikely we're going to see Recruiter of the Guard, Flickerwisp's best friend. Recruiter of the Guard is the white mirror to Imperial Recruiter, the one that searches for toughness 2 or less, where Imperial Recruiter looks for power 2 or less. The main reason I wanted to see Recruiter of the Guard was for Flickerwisp. I will not lie to you, I'm a big fan of the old Flickerwisp. Oh well, we'll have to wait for Modern Horizons 3 for that, but with Imperial Recruiter coming into the format, I thought I would do a top 5 video of my picks of things I'm excited to play with, or things I think people are going to be fetching with Imperial Recruiter. So gather round, pull up a chair, get yourself in front of the greatest beard in esports entertainment, draw warmth from me, warm your soul like my chin is a hearth. In at number 5, I'm going to put clones. Yeah, okay, it's kind of a safe bet, right? But specifically, I'm talking about Phantasmal Image. What better way to utilize your tutor than to immediately tutor for another tutor with your tutor? What you have to remember is that Recruiter looks for power 2 or less, so anything that has a power of 0 in your deck is fetchable, and this will come in a moment as well. This means you can grab Clone itself, or more likely in a situation like Modern, a Singleton Silver Bullet Phantasmal Image. This will allow you to go again with Recruiter, widening your board, or copying another vital piece in play, whether that be a Mana Dork on your side of the board, an Anthem Effect on a body, or something your opponent has played that's kind of scary, like a Grizzlebrand or similar. I know it's not particularly thrilling to put Clone in at number 5, but it's a safe bet that at some point it will be grabbing a Phantasmal Image in some sort of toolbox deck. In at number 4, I put Thalia's Lieutenant, which is probably more boring than Clones in my humble opinion. This is quite possibly the most common one to be grabbed by this, I would bet. If Recruiter ends up predominantly in the very fair and also very aggressive humans deck in Modern, he will either go grabbing Silver Bullet hate pieces like Thalia to fight combo, or things like this that benefit your strategy of going wide. Don't forget that on turn 2, if you put a Vial on turn 1, it'll be on 2. So on turn 3, you can untap, play your land, tap out for a Recruiter, grab a Thalia's Lieutenant, activate your Vial, and widen your board and pump the whole team. It's a pretty good turn 3. At number 3, I've got Magus of the Moon. I mentioned above about grabbing hate pieces like Thalia or specific silver bullets. Well, Magus of the Moon's a hate piece for the majority of the format because no one's playing any bloody basics. Now, Magus itself is unlikely to be in the humans deck because the mana base for humans is pretty bad as it is and doesn't play any basics traditionally, or just one singular forest. Your non-basics help you play a 4 or 5 color deck, so Magus isn't an option there. But there are older toolbox decks that some of my other picks go into that I think can make use of Magus alongside the Recruiter. Personally, I'm going to try using Recruiter in Red, White, Yeth, and Taxes to go and grab things like Leon and Arbiter's, Thalia's, and Magus of the Moon, and then reset them with Flickerwisps and Restos. Of course, the tutor doesn't quite work with Leon and Arbiter, but yeah, that's what I'll be playing Magus of the Moon. In at number 2, we have Kiki Jiki Mirror Breaker and 2 others. It's like a triple 3-for-1 deal here. Kiki Jiki, Pestermite, and Exarch. It's probably the most exciting and obvious synergy with Recruiter, so much so that the extended art version in Modern Horizons 2 literally has Kiki Jiki and Pestermite in the art. Honestly, it's pretty wild that Recruiter gets both halves of the combo, both Kiki, the engine card as it were, and the things he needs to copy to untap himself. Kiki plus Pestermite or Exarch is infinite creatures with haste, and that means infinite power, which means a kill on board, and Recruiter gets both halves of the combo. Kiki Cord was the toolbox deck that I was thinking of the most when Recruiter got spoiled. It's a deck that could play singular with Silver Bullets thanks to Cord of Calling. And I think that Phantasmal Image and Megas the Moon and Kiki in the combo, they could all fit into the same sort of toolboxy deck that I've mentioned here. So all of the prior mentioned slots could fit into this option. I've said number two, but this is number... Nope, this is number two. I'm very professional at keeping track of my notes comment section. The biggest problem of Kiki Cord in the past was its mana base again, similar to humans in many ways. It plays a lot of green sources to be able to play, well, Accelerance in Mana Dorks and the titular Cord, the tutor. The addition of like Imperial Recruiter to the mix means you could move away from green entirely, still have your blue-red combo and still have your red tutor, so you can go to like blue-red control. Problem being, tapping out for Omegas for three mana at sorcery speed to choose in your red-blue control deck is a little rough. The other issue we have is whether Kiki Jiki itself, the combo, is good enough, fast enough in current modern to deal with the selection of combo and aggressive strategies that exist now. And on that note, let's talk about my final pick for cards that Imperial Recruiter can tutor for. This is probably an obvious one as well, but it's Walking Ballista. I've done an entire video myself talking about why the Walking Ballista is just too good and how it's too easy to cast and it homogenized combo decks as a combo finisher for multiple reasons. It's colorless nature, so it doesn't cost you any particular colors of mana. It can win through combat damage if your opponent is hexproof, and it can also win through damage if your opponent has an ensnaring breach in play as well. Walking Ballista is a pretty strong magic card. Like I said before, Walking Ballista is a 0-0 in the deck, so Recruiter can go and find it. And Walking Ballista has already seen some play like this in Legacy, where Food Chain is bant using the white Recruiter, Recruit of the Guard, to go find Walking Ballista, make infinite mana, and kill your opponent. Now, at time of recording, Food Chain has been spoiled. That'll make this video even better if Food Chain is spoiled before this video gets out. So, yeah, I think even if there's in the deck right now that wants to go and grab Walking Ballista is red and green or red and white or whatever to combo off with, there may be one in the future. And if you get the Heli combo, it is green-white, maybe it will resort to splashing into red for a better tutor, although green still gives you Cord and Company and such. And this extends a little bit into my honorable mention, which is Thassa's Oracle. Thassa's Oracle is similar to Walking Ballista, not in it being colorless or anything, but it is just better than most options, and it has started to homogenize combo decks with other formats, and it has been banned in Historic for that reason. So if we ever see a Horizon set that gives us a Doomsday style effect, for example, on a body, which isn't outside the realms of possibility, then we might see Thassa's Oracle be the thing that Imperial Recruiter has to grab instead of Walking Ballista. Basically, this slot is combo finisher that isn't Kiki, but it's mainly going to be Walking Ballista. So what do you think? What do you think of my five picks for things that people will grab with Imperial Recruiter? What do you think about the amount of times I've said the words Imperial Recruiter in this video? Like, they're starting to lose all meaning for me. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Let me know if you enjoyed this format of video. It's a bit different. Someone else is editing it that isn't me on ChannelFireball.com. And don't forget, if you're using the link down below to pick up some stuff from ChannelFireball.com, use my code Kenobi at checkout to help support me and the channel. There'll be a link down below to my YouTube as well. And I'll see you in the next video. Ta-ta for now.